Every curious mind has lots of unanswered questions about our universe and celestial bodies. So, let's begin the question-answer session.
Do all objects in the universe exert a force on each other?
They exert a gravitational force on each other, but the magnitude of this force depends on the mass of the body.
How is it measured?
You can actually have a situation in which you hang two objects in a perfectly isolated environment in laboratory and see how they move towards each other. Cavendish did that. So you can actually measure it basically all measurements of force is done by changes in motion. So you hang two objects and see how they get closer to each other. Right?
So it is applicable in the entire universe?
Yes.
Yeah. It's the same. We measure everything by change of motion. All forces are measured by change of motion.
I heard somewhere that when two very large mass, two objects having a large mass are falling into each other, they first circulate around each other. So if one is of 25x mass and one is of 36x mass, so when they collapse, the new mass that is formed is much lesser than their total addition. So why does that?
Energy is liberated. Energy and mass are equivalent. So, from a conceptual point of view, that's it. I mean, there's some energy liberated. I mean, and of course, it's not as if this, E equals mc squared. I mean, as in the energy that's liberated is all the rest mass is completely, no. The efficiency is pretty small. But it can happen that the new object that's formed is of a smaller mass than the sum of the masses of its parent bodies. The difference will be liberated in some kind of energy. The details are quite complex and